All right. Firme o qué? How you do today? Doing two paintings at once today. Just to get them done. Did some art that's now on display. Really? Fantastic. You got a link to. That's great. What kind of art was that? There's a ship that has a museum about it, and the fishing port. Public can go on whales. I drew a side view of the wheelhouse and you gave it to them. Excellent, well done. So yeah, that's a great achievement. Where's can I ask where what museum it is, what town it's in? Was it watercolor? Would you prefer to paint? That's the sort of stuff you usually paint. Not many people say that they're in their artworks in a museum. Hear me okay? Yeah. Audio okay. Audio okay. these two paintings are quite similar, but the eyes are different. Thank you.
Thank you.
Solar feather. Yeah. Having a good day. It's gonna be thunder and lightning here about 4 o'clock. Awful hot. I'm fine, thanks. This week I was doing four portraits in the style of Betty Boop. So like Monday, did this one. It sort of looks a wee bit Michael Jackson-esque, doesn't it? So I say that turned out pretty good. So yesterday I started this one. I've to finish this background and do a wee bit of touch ups and stuff. So I'm gonna finish that one, and then I've got these two in the same coat, which are pretty similar. But some slightly difference in them. Which that's today's plan. Yeah, acrylics. What I'm doing with them is, they're so versatile. I'm using them almost like a watercolour, putting them in layers. No thick paint at all. Doing is I'm just putting a wee bit of water to keep them nice and smooth. I've not burnt. They're very, very forgiving. What is it that you use mostly? They're so versatile. Like that, I started in watercolours. Purely watercolours. It took me a long time to sort of. I tried oils, but oils were taking too long. And the fumes and stuff, So when I went to acrylics, I could do everything that. So you can, lay it on thick layers, or you can lay like normal paint, or you can use like a watercolour and just layer upon layer upon layer. Yeah, gouache is good as well. Well, if you think like you've got watercolours, then you've got gouache, which is like a more sort of thicker big paint. And then you go up to acrylics, it's the best of that sort of both worlds. I would highly recommend using them. And then what I've done is I put the paint in these wee pots. They either use there's a thing called flow improver. So it liquidizes it a wee bit. Or what I do is I just use water. Water it down. You also get this stuff called gloss medium, which is kind of like a varnish, but you can put it in. You can put it into the paint as well. It sort of gives a sort of glossy look. So if you're looking for like a nice sort of shiny texture and stuff, this is that's the stuff to use. You don't need to. You just use it. Acrylic on its own, which you get it in tubes and stuff, but this paint here is like, it's almost like toothpaste, this one. Even like a wee bit thinner than toothpaste, and you can layer that up. You can put it on like a cream cake, as if you're making a birthday cake, or you can water it down and stuff. So it's really, really versatile. Yeah. Like I says, I'm really happy with the results and stuff I'm getting with that. Yeah. Plan today, what you up to? Nice and nice. Sleep. That's what I plan to do after this. You like sleeping? I wish you got paid for sleeping, eh? I was hoping to do some painting actually, but these thunderstorms are making me sleepy. I think it's gone into the spell, innit? Really hibernating through the winter. Start with a sketch and see how it feels. Excellent. Yeah. He's looking at his crystal. Hey. I think I'm happy with that. Yes. Great, just good. Okay, Ash, no worries. Hope you're okay, man. Hope you had a good day. Okay, folks. I will call it a day and say, oh, I'll have a new project, so. Getting fed up seeing these. So do something then. Thanks for watching, everybody. Much appreciated, and have a great day, everybody. I'll be back tomorrow. Bye for now.